Hello all, I'm Viral from electronicsinvestment.com. I'm your host for this episode. In this video, we will look into how to develop auto-activation based LoRa and nodes with Arduino Nano and RFM95 modules. First of all, visit the Things Network server and come to the ThingsTech Community Edition. We have already worked on these two sections in the previous videos. In one of the previous episodes, we had set up LPS8 gateway and registered here on the Things Network server. Currently the gateway is up and running seamlessly. You can also see the gateway status connected. In another video, we have seen how to create an application in the Things Network server. In the same video, we have created a couple of ABP activation based LoRa and nodes and activated them on the Things Network server. Now we will add auto activation based LoRa and nodes and work on them. Click on Add End Device. Go to the manual selection and select the frequency band allowed in your country. Select the Mac version V1.0.3. Click on Show Advanced Activation Settings. Make sure activation mode is OTA over the air activation. Keep the rest of the settings default. Generate Dev UI and App UI. Generally, App UI will be filled with zeros. Then generate Application Key. Finally, click on Register the End Device. That's it, a new device has been created and here we got activation information for the configuration of the device. Let us build the LoRa and node with Arduino Nano and RFM95 module. Here is the circuit diagram to interface RFM95 with Arduino Nano. After connections, the circuit might be something like this. Before stepping into the programming part, I would like to take a moment and thank PCB.com for sponsoring this video by sending the external PCBs. This RFM95 module is not breadboard friendly, so I have designed an external PCB and ordered on the PCBWay.com. PCBWay.com is an online PCB manufacturing enterprise which provides all services you need to make hardware for your IoT or embedded devices. If you have a similar requirement, do check out their website for more details. The link is in the description below. Now open Arduino IDE. Here we are going to use IBM LMIC Framework Library for LoRa. This library can be installed from the Arduino Library Manager. Go to the examples from the file menu and search for IBM LMIC Framework and open TTN OTA example. We will use this code to program the LoRa and node. But before that, we need to provide the device activation information. Go to the TTN website. Click on this to convert the key into the array of hexadecimal numbers. And make sure it will be in LSB format, least significant bit format. Copy the app UI and replace in the Arduino sketch. Repeat the same process for Dev UI. Make sure it will be in LSB format. For the application key, click on the View button. Convert the key into the array of hexadecimal numbers and make sure it will be in MSB format. Most significant bit format. Copy application key and replace it in the Arduino code. Change this message whatever you want. Then set the interval to 15 seconds. Change the pin configurations according to the circuit diagram. That could be something like this. That's it. There are no other changes in the Arduino sketch. But make sure you have added the frequency channels according to the frequency band you have selected. If there is any mismatch in the frequency channels, the device will not communicate with the gateway. We have already discussed this part in the previous videos. You can check out that video for more information. Once everything is ready, connect the Arduino Nano to the laptop using any USB interface. Then check uploading configurations, board Arduino Nano and select the right port. Then click on uploading button. After successful uploading, open the serial monitor. The following text on the serial monitor represents the LoRa and node initiated the joining request. Now open the Things Network server and go to the live data of the application section. As you can see here, the join request has been accepted by the network server and the device transmitted first data packet. The data packet contains the message we are sending from the device. This is the encrypted data we have sent. The data is decrypted and converted into human readable format. I have already done this decryption process for this application in the previous video. That's why the data is automatically decrypted and converted to human readable format. The decryption process will applicable to the whole application. That is why it is automatically done. The uplink messages are being received by the network server seamlessly for the configured time period. This is how we will develop auto activation based LoRa and Node with Arduino Nano and RFM95 module. We can change the dummy message and transfer some useful sensor data to the network server. Then the data can be transferred to any application server for long-term storage and to visualize the data to the customers. I will try to make a project on that soon. I hope you have learned something new from this episode. Stay tuned to Electronics Innovation for more videos on LoRaWAN. See you soon on the next interesting project. Bye-bye.